today we will talk about the overlay protocol, which runs on the SD-WAN, which is the OMP, Overlay Management Protocol. So today our agenda would be the SD-WAN overlay routing overview, OMP routes advertisement, OMP route redistribution with network segmentation, and configuring and verifying the overlay routing. Right. So basically, what is the overlay routing? So overlay routing enables the distribution of routing information across all sites, right, within a VPN. It may be your sites like branch, cloud, data center, home, right, your campus, everywhere, wherever you have an underlay over which you have configured overlay routing, right? So with the help of overlay routing, you can send your data traffic by use of your underlay, right? So with the help of overlay routing, we can distribute the routing information of all our VPNs, right? And what is the VPN? In SD-WAN, VPNs, in we say VPNs as a, I mean our LAN, right? So there are three types of VPNs available. That is VPN 0. VPN 0 will be mostly used for WAN connectivity, right? So whenever your VH will be connected to either MPLS, either internet or 4G, 5G, 3G, LTE, anything, it would be a part of VPN 0. There will be another VPN we say as a VPN 512. This is used for your out of band management, right? So if you want to use out of band management traffic, you should put that subnet or an interface in a VPN 512. And from VPN 12, there is a range, right? Till there, you can configure a service VPN. So service VPN is mostly your LAN part, or the subnets which you are receiving if your VS router is further connected to any another router, and that router is further connected to any branch location or some other sites, right? So overlay routing provides a scalable solution. Why? Because with the help of overlay routing, you can scale your number of sites, as many sites, there is no such restriction, right? But I mean, if you say about practical solution, no sites has more than, you know, more than thousands sites. If I don't talk about the financial sites, right, like banks. So if you talk about SBI has 10,000 branches. But if we don't talk about any banks related stuff, normal corporate, normal enterprise environment like manufacturing, retail, hospitality, not more than 500 sites or 700 sites are there. So you can scale your overlay network. You can add as many as VPNs you want, and those VPNs routing information can be shared with the help of overlay routing. So overlay routing in SD-WAN, this overlay routing can be achieved by a protocol we say as a overlay management routing protocol. So OMP protocol is used to share your VPN, service VPN information or a routing prefix information from one VH to another VH via vSmart, right? So let's suppose you have a very much service VPN configured here, right? Now your VH will be connected to vSmart via DTLS tunnel. So, and OMP will be running here. So all your VH router, right, and all your service VPNs will be redistributed into the OMP, so that with the help of OMP, that route will be propagated to vSmart. And from vSmart, with the help of OMP, that route will be again sent to next VH router. So OMP runs on your Cisco Webtela WAN fabric. That means this will be your WAN part. Here you have connected your, routers, right? So this will be your OMP. And from here, these are all your service VPN. Then you have to redistribute your service VPN routes to the OMP. Now, what does the OMP, what is the key role of OMP? OMP has a key role in terms of orchestrator, right? It acts as an orchestrator in terms of sharing the routing information or a providing a secure connectivity between sites. First thing, it also provides the service chaining so that if you have, if any of your sites has the, you know, firewall connectivity, or if let's suppose this is your VH and it has a firewall connectivity and you have a route, right? So this route is, we say, as a service chaining route. That route you can also advertise to your OMP. So service chaining can be achieved. VPN topologies, segmentation you can achieve based on different VPNs. You can configure your LAN, right? So first thing, that OMP plays a role of orchestrator. Second thing, OMP plays a role of distribution of routes, right? So all your service routes will be shared between your VHs via vSmart over OMP. The distribution of data plane security parameter, whatever security parameter that will be required to send your data traffic, right? That security parameter will be shared by OMP. Let's remember yesterday I said that remote key of all the VH sites will be shared via OMP so that your VH router will encrypt your traffic via another side VH router and it will send it. And also the control, central control plane and distribution of routing policies. These are all the key role of OMP. All the central control policy or a distribution routing policies, which you will configure on a vSmart, right? That will be shared with the help of OMP protocol. Right? So this is how, you know, your overlay routing OMP works. This is here your OMP works, right? And this is all your VHs. Let's suppose S1 route has a OSPF. And let's suppose it has a 10.10.10.0/24. It has a 11.11.11.0/24. It has a static route. Let's suppose default route it has, right? And it has some connected route. Let's suppose 12.12.12.0/0. All will be redistributed to the OMP. Why? Because your OMP works here, and with the help of OMP, all these routes will be shared to each of your sites, right? So that each VH router in each site will learn the prefix of all the other VH sites that are a part of certain VPNs. So OMP learns and translates the routing informations across the VPN overlay. Now, OMP details. OMP details are, it is pre-configured at bring up. You don't have to enable it. It will be pre-configured. It will be enabled by default, right? OMP, it establishes a secure connections between your VH and vSmart, right, with the help of DTLS tunnel or a TLS tunnel and having a AES-256 key encryption so that all your service routes will be sent via OMP updates and it will be encrypted so that nothing, you know, hacking can be happened in between your communication of OMP updates between your VHS router and vSmart, right? And the endpoint are system IP. Right, so I'll talk about what is the system IP later. I mean, sometime later during this topic. But it is at a nutshell, OMP is pre-configured. It establishes a secure connections between your VH and vSmart, right? And a secure connection can be achieved by a DTLS tunnel or a TTLS tunnel with the help of AES-256 key encryption mechanism. Now, what are all OMP routes we have? OMP routes we have, we say as a V routes or OMP route. This is the first type of route. Second route we say as a TLOC, and third route we say as a service route. So let's understand what is the OMP routes. OMP routes are those routes which are simple a prefix which your VSS has learned from site local. So that means if this is your VH router, and from VH router you have connected your, this is your service VPN. So this service VPN routes will be your OMP routes. To make it analogy, we say as a, it is a prefix of BGP or your network. It may be your LAN, or it may be connected to some other router. There they connected to some of the sites, right? So all your service VPN subnets are, we say as a OMP routes. That is why we say as a service side. Now, what is the TLOC? TLOC is a transport locator. In a very easy term, we say as a next hop of BGP. So what happens? Let's suppose I have a router. I have a 192.168.1.1. Here I have a 192.168.1.2. And I have a subnet 10.10.10.0/24. When I, this router R1 will advertise its route to R2, R2 will put 10.10.10.10. Next hop is 192.168.1.1. So that means if from R2, if I want to reach to 10.10.10.10.0, I have to send my traffic to this next hop. So TLOC is we say as a next hop of BGP, right? It is, we say as a transport locator. It ties with OMP routes, right? So all your service VPNs, I mean OMP routes, will be tied up with TLOC, right? Why? Because next hop must be, advertised, so that all your other site VHS router must know that to reach X subnet, Y subnet, or Z subnet, what will be my TLOC. But TLOC is not a simple next hop. It is a tuple of some of things. It has three field, main field. Apart from it, it has some attribute also. Likewise, OMP routes, we say as a service side subnet, but it also contains some attributes. Just like we say as when we advertise a BGP route, that BGP prefix has some attributes, associated with, like next hop, like local preference, like MED, like AS, right path. So just like a BGP prefix says, OMP routes also has some attributes. TLOC we say as a next hop of BGP, or it is a next hop of my prefixes. But it is not only a single next hop, but it contains some attribute also. I will come later. Is that service routes are those routes which are configured for your firewall. If there is a firewall, on some of your sites, and there is a route to that, that route will be said as a service route, and that will be used for your service chaining mechanism, right? These service routes are also tied to the OMP routes while advertising. So all these route types, overlay management protocol route types, under which there are three types of route: OMP routes, TLOC routes, and service routes. Make sense? Now, let's talk about, how the OMP route flows, right? So let's suppose you have a site, right? Here you have a TLOC 172.1.10.1, right? This site, let's suppose this is site 2, this is site 1, this is site 3, and this is your vSmart. So all your sites VHS will create a DTLS tunnel to the vSmart. Now let's talk about site 1. On the site one, I have a OSPF route, which we say as a 10.2.50.0. So OSPF is running between here and here, right? And from OSPF, my VH router is learning 10.2.50.0. So This router will advertise subnet 10.2.50.0/24 to vSmart. Now let's talk about, this is my TLOC, this is my OMP routes, 2.50.0/24. So from this VS router, I am advertising my OMP routes. So my OMP route type is first thing, OMP route, I advertise it. Now second will be my TLOC. What will be my TLOC of 10.2.50.0? My system IP. You can use your system IP as a TLOC, or you can also use your WAN IP as a TLOC. So it depends upon which TLOC you want to advertise, right? So let's suppose I use as a system IP as a TLOC, I'm advertising it. So this VS router will advertise 172.1.10.1/32, let's suppose, as a TLOC to your vSmart. Now I have a static route pointing towards my firewall on a VH2, and we say that service routes are also advertised in OMP routes, right? Prefix OMP updates. So if I have a service route which is pointing to my firewall, that static route will also advertise to my vSmart as a service route via OMP updates. So these three types of routes are advertised from each VH router to your vSmart controller, and from vSmart controller these routes are processed. If there is a policy you have configured, right, that will be applied. If you want some routes to be modified, if you want some routes to be, you know, dropped while re-advertising it again, that policy will be processed, and then your vSmart will advertise those routes to another VS router like that.
Hello.
Yep.
Just one question, a quick one.
Yep.
As you can see on any diagrams which we are following, vSmart plays a very important role, which is doing the control part.
Correct.
Is it right that you have only one vSmart?
No.
You
can have a multiple vSmart. I mean, for redundancy, you can have one. We should have. In a production environment, there must be, multiple vSmart. But in a lab environment, we say, it's max enough. Why? Because we only want to understand the capability and we see the, you know, what vSmart can do and how we can achieve our target or a goal to configure the things, and we learn the lab part, right?
Okay. And definitely there will be a DTLS between the vSmarts.
Yep.
Okay. Fine.
Now, let's talk about what OMP routes will be advertised, right? So I say that OMP has three types of routes. One will be OMP route. Second will be TLOC for that OMP. And third will be service routes if we have in our environment. And what is service route? Service fire routes are those routes which we use for, you know, we have configured for a firewall, or we have configured a load balancer and we want that our traffic should go to the firewall. That routes we say as a service routes. So now let's talk about OMP routes. As I said earlier, that OMP routes is your service VPN routes, plus it has some attribute also, right? So what are your service VPN routes? I mean, site local routes. Site local routes are, if I have a router, this is my site local router. Why? Because these are connected. It may be directly connected. If I have a static route, if I am learning some route via OSPF, or if I am learning some route via BGP, right? I mean, those routers will be connected back into my VH, right? So those routes which are connected, static, BGP and OSPF route, these are called as a OMP routes. I mean, these routes will be advertised to the vSmart via OMP updates. And what are all attributes it has? It has VPN ID. This is the prefix, right? So let's suppose you receive 10.2.50.0, 10.2.51.128, 10.2.52.0, 10.2.53.0. These routes you have received from any of your VHS, right? And it's now installed in your branch router. So how your OMP router will look like? So to see the OMP routes, you have to show IP route. It is a command through which you will see that what are my OMP routes that my router has learned. So once you put this command, you will see that these four routes I have learned via OMP, and this is my static and connected routes. These routes are a part of VPN1, right? Via protocol, it can have a next hop if name. It doesn't have anything. Next hop IP addresses. This is your TLOC, right? Through which, you know, link I have received that route. Gold means you have. Let's suppose you have configured any internet link and you have made it and you have configured a color gold, right? So if we talk about SD-WAN, whatever WAN a link we configure, we provide a color to it, right? So let's suppose I have an internet link and I have used a gold color for that, right? Encapsulation will be IPsec. So the attribute will be, apart from these prefixes, what will be your attribute? TLOC, system IP of root originator, right? Color, encapsulation, site ID, through which, you know, from which site ID you have received those root, VPN ID, what is your VPN ID, any preference, originator ID, originator of the routes, origin tag, if you have any tags, I mean, this is optional one, if you have any tag you have attached to your prefixes. So these all attribute will be present for all your OMP routes and will be advertised via one VH router to the vSmart and from vSmart to another VS router, and another all other VS router will install those OMP routes in its routing table with all these attributes, showing all these attributes.